And well, guys, on your week's review with Alice Digital, NetCC revealed he just got vaccinated in the United States of America in his latest video. 25K signs to Sony Music Africa. Lucas Raps is proving to be the biggest baller in SA hip hop right now, as he recently just purchased a 14 million grand house and released a track featuring American rapper K Cash. MT details plans to grow MT Records into more than just a record label. Plus, Blackie announces that he's going to be dropping a new video featuring STC. And well, starting off with Casper Nyovest, he just signed a 100 million rands deal with Drip, which they jointly announced as a partnership and is going to be called Root of Fame. MT detailed plans to turn MT Records into more than a record label during his interview with Drum Magazine. And while he said that, "My dream is to help and discover new talent, and I would love to venture into sports management, maybe sign a few pro athletes into MT Records as their media agency, and lastly, to own a union for the rights of all the creatives on our continent." Stilo Magolide revealed on Twitter that he got stabbed by Asgard, as well as sharing the pictures of his hand that was cut by the knife, of which Asgard co-founder Mpo did respond by saying that if Stilo wants to fight, then he's ready. Nota reveals in an Instagram post that he offered AKA and Casper Nyovest a million rands each to do a joint album, of which, judging by the current state of affairs, has not happened and probably won't happen. And while we said that, "I offered AKA and Casper Nyovest a million rands each to do a joint album. I still have that money on the table. Who does it make sense for me to offer that money to?" Ntseki Mazwai received backlash when she mentioned that El Tito, Max, and Questa are her favorite rappers, but mentioned that she finds NCC a bit mediocre. Some GBV organizations ignited calls to mute AKA after he posted an Instagram status of himself smoking and playing a track by Travis Scott featuring Kanye West titled "Peace on Your Grave." And while the reason why most people were offended by this is because just about a month and a half back, AKA just buried his fiance, Andile Tembe, who passed away after dropping from the 10th floor of a hotel. Some felt it was a bit too early for AKA to be posting statuses jamming to songs like that. And well, guys, it seems Ifan is back. And not only is he back, he just dropped a track when he was featured by Big Gosser titled "Ikuku Ndlala Remix." And not only that, he also did give some advice to Big Gosser on Twitter. And while we said that music video done, referring to the Ikuku Ndlala music video, and he said that Big Gosser is a dope kid, a young Dylan, a great soul. "I wish him all the success ahead and more, and no downfall like me. No AKA like people killing his dreams, and I wish he numbs his crush unlike Boti and I. And now I'm back in the studio." Coming to Tseho, he just explained that he's in talks with American rapper Bass to have a possible collaboration. This was during an interview with Brad Berish, when he said that, "I met Bass and he was like down here in Johannesburg for the first time. And he hit me up in the DM and said, 'Just listen, bro. I really love the work and I want to link, and it's kept up to date with me. So, you know, that energy is real energy. That is why I can speak on it. But, you know, I'm doing my best to get the craziest features. At the same time, it is not just the US that I'm focused on. I'm open to the UK. I'm open to Niger. Right now, Nigeria is going crazy." Big Gosser revealed as well that he's not going to be signing to any record label after a tweet saying that, "I'm not signing to any labels. Thank you for the offers though." And looking at the reaction, the majority of his fans support the decision. NCC just revealed that he got vaccinated in the United States of America in his latest video for "Best I Ever Had," of which he showed a little snippet of him actually getting the injection, as well as a tweet saying that, "I just got the chip." Coming to the drops, Pretty Ugly just dropped a track titled "The Pan" featuring Youngster CPT. Okay, Malume Coolcare just released 100K Macosset mixtape for the second time as a re-release, as the first one was released around 2015. 25K just dropped the intro to his upcoming and highly anticipated album, Pele Machiavelli. Coming back to 25K, it seems he just signed a new deal with Sony Music Africa ahead of his highly anticipated album drop. Blackie's single, Big Time Slapper, featuring Lucas Raps, just reached over a million views on YouTube. Plus, he just announced he's going to be dropping his music video featuring NCC today, and it will drop at around 4. On some other news, NCC just shared his new tattoo that he got while he's in the States. It is basically a neck tattoo, and it looks like a bird and a Bible at the same time. Black Coffee as well just announced some sort of tour, as he shared some sort of back-to-back shows in the United States of America, and he titled it, "Words Can't Explain How Incredible It Feels to Announce a Run of Shows. We are back," in capital letters. Lucas Raps proves to be the biggest balling South African rapper at this moment, as he just announced a purchase of a house worth over 14 million rands. Not only that, he just recently released a track featuring American rapper K Cash titled Regular Shit. And well guys, just like that, we've come to the end of this week's A-List Digital's Week Review. And this week's Artist of the Week is Wa Jamson with his track Fruition. And burning, burning like my shorty Serafina. I love and burning, made it start right. I was trying to get it off, right. I was trying to get it with my... And well, if you want to bump to the song, I'll make sure I leave the link in the description below just so you guys can listen more to it. I was trying to get it with my dimes, couple O's, with my highs, couple pros. With my flows, couple niggas really looking for an activist and activated.